Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to go over tips and tricks on how I prepared to pass the real estate exam. So if you're someone who is currently in real estate school, someone preparing to take the test, or just overall interested in starting real estate, then definitely keep on watching. So first and foremost, here in Rhode Island, it's a 45-hour requirement to complete the course. So I signed up at an accredited school here in Rhode Island, completed the course in person. I do think that it helped me out tremendously taking the course in person. So let's go over the books that I got when I signed up, which was the big real estate book. And then we were also given a Rhode Island state law book as well. So the test is broken up into two, which is the Rhode Island is the real estate course, and then the law portion of it as well. First and foremost, the number one most important thing that helped me study and helped me pass is actually understanding the terms and not just memorizing. Now, first off, I mean, this is going to be your career. Actually understanding what you're learning is very important and not just memorizing. Also, understanding the terms is going to help you out so much on the test, because the test will try to confuse you and throw in extra verbiage or extra things in the question that typically you don't need to know, or that typically doesn't need to be in the question. So if you understand the term and the vocab, then you'll have no problem passing this exam. So things that I did to help me understand was, number one, making flashcards. So I made flashcards for every single vocab word in the book, literally every single one of them. So what I would do after every chapter and after every class is that I would go home and I would write every single vocab word that was in that chapter and the definitions on the back of them. And I would go through every single one of them and study them and study them and study them until I knew that definition and understood that word completely. Once I got every single vocab word correctly, I would take the unit exam after every single chapter that we just did in class. So for instance, if we did chapters 1 and 2 in class, I would write out the vocab words of each chapter. I would go through the whole stack of flashcards until I was able to get the entire stack correct. And then I would take the unit exam at the end of that chapter. All the answers to the unit exam are at the end of the book. So I would just circle what I thought was correct, and then I would go to the end of the book. And for anyone that I would get wrong, I would reread that entire section in the book until I completely and fully understood what I was studying. Another thing that I did that I think really helped me out was I didn't take any notes during the course. I sat there and listened and tried to take in as much as possible rather than sitting there writing out notes that I probably wouldn't have read now that I think about it. So instead of taking notes, what I would do is I would highlight every single thing that the teacher would say was important. And sometimes he would give us some hints on what was gonna be on the test, and I would make sure to highlight that. So at the end of each class, while I was making my flashcards, after I did the unit exam, I would go through everything that I highlighted and I would reread it and make sure that I understood it as well too. Majority of it is vocab, but I just think it's a lot easier for me to go back and look at what I highlighted to make sure that what he was telling us is important and what he thinks is on the test that I knew. Another thing that I would do is, while I was studying my vocab words, I would try to come up with little tricks and different things to help me remember what they meant. So for instance, if I'm going back into the book, there's a section about, just to kind of give you guys an example of what I mean by this. So one of the sections would be surface, subsurface, and air rights. So basically I would say, okay, so one of the vocab words is reprimand rights, which is the rights to an owner along the course of a river, stream, or similar flowing body of water, which would be reprimand rights. So I would say, okay, reprimand starts with an R, river, rivers, and also a stream. So those are basically smaller bodies of water. That's how I would understand what reprimand rights meant. Then you have littoral rights, or littoral rights, however you want to say it. And those are rights for owners who land borders commercial lakes, seas, and oceans. So literal, I say, okay, legal for some reason reminds me of commercial. L, also lakes and oceans are bigger bodies of water, and that's how I would differentiate between littoral and riparian rights. So hopefully that makes sense. And to kind of dig a little bit deeper, you have another section here that is assertion, erosion, and avulsion. So the way I would try to differentiate or understand the difference between assertion, erosion, and avulsion is, okay, so assertion is increasing the land resulting from the deposit of soil by the water's actions. So I would say, okay, assertion starts with an A. A, adding. So it's adding deposit of soil by water. So I would say, okay, assertion and adding, that's how I would connect the two. And then erosion is gradually wearing away the land by natural forces. I would say, okay, erosion starts with an E, so it is eliminating. So I would connect erosion with eliminating, and that's how I would understand that definition. And then avulsion, I kind of, for some reason, I would say, okay, avulsion has V in it, that's violent, that's the sudden removal of soil by the act of nature. And I just picture that as like a violent, like that's like a tornado, an earthquake, or like a mudslide or something. So I would say, so that would be considered violent to me. So that's how I would connect avulsion with that definition. So just little tips and just little tricks and like things like that. So when I come across that word in the test, I can think back at the way I associated that word with the definition. So hopefully that makes sense and that just didn't confuse you. That's just one way of me understanding and remembering the definitions to these words, because I'm not a very good test taker. I'm not a very good studier. So I need to come up with different ways to help me understand and remember certain terms and understanding the terminology and the context of these words and so forth. So that was something that really helped me out tremendously, because a lot of these words are kind of grouped together for different types of things, and you need to know the difference between a lot of these words. And that was one way for me to kind of differentiate the words and understand them better. Another thing that I did as well too is basically what you guys are doing right now, is I watched a lot of YouTube videos on different tips and tricks that other agents that took the test did, as well as different tips and tricks that they had, and would watch videos on what people said were on the test so I knew what to really study for. And the last thing that I did, which I did about a week or maybe 2 weeks before I actually took the test, was I bought a program called Prep Agent. Now this is no way sponsored whatsoever by them, obviously, but it did help me out tremendously. So rather than the flashcards of just terms and vocab, this kind of brought it a little bit deeper and gave me different scenarios, and I would have to answer that way. And it was about, I think it's like 27, it's between like $25 and $35 for 7 days. And basically you just sign up for this course and they just give you a bunch of questions that you have to answer. And regardless if you got the answer right or wrong, if once you submit that answer, it gives you basically a breakdown or a description as to either why that answer was right or why that answer was wrong. So you can actually dive a little bit deeper into the meaning of the questions, which helped me out a lot, to be honest with you, because I feel like a lot of the things that were on a lot of those questions were really on the test. So I feel like doing that about a week or 2 weeks before I actually took the test helped me out so much. They also have a YouTube channel that I watched as well too, where the owner of Prep Agent would quiz a lot of his other clients, and I would just kind of watch the dialogue between the two of them, and that really just helped me learn a lot more about real estate. That way when I took the test, obviously just a lot more came to me easier and I didn't have to think about it and I knew the answer to them. Like I said, it's more about understanding the vocab and understanding the concept rather than just memorizing, you know, a word to a definition. Because to be honest, I mean, this is going to be your career. It's going to be something that you're going to be doing for a long time, hopefully. And you're going to want, I mean, you're going to want to know everything there is about real estate if you're going to become an agent. So you don't want to just, like in high school where you know, tried to pass a test for a course that you didn't even care about and you just wanted to get that A or get that B for it. This is something that you want to pass because it's going to be your career. It's going to be something that you're going to be doing for a long time and you're going to be helping people and you want to be knowledgeable in this field. So obviously the experience is going to come with time and the knowledge is going to come with time, but knowing the basics of what you learn in class is going to help you out a lot. Obviously you're going to learn a lot more when you're actually out on the field working under a broker and working, you know, either within a team or as a solo agent, but it's very important that you know what you're doing. So definitely study, dive in as much as you can. Understand everything as much as you possibly can. That way when you go into that test, there's no hesitation of answering those questions. You know everything and you'll pass with flying colors. Another thing on the test, and just a little tip that I want to throw in there that I did on the test as well too, when I actually took the test, there was this option to flag a question to go back to it. So I wasn't focusing so much time on one question because one, it is a timed test and I don't remember how long the time is. I believe it's maybe 4 hours. I think I did take pretty much 3 hours, maybe a little bit more to take it because I did take my time taking this test. It's not something I wanted to fly through. I really wanted to read the questions in its entirety and make sure I answered correctly. If there's a question that it came about that I didn't know the answer to right off the top of my head and I wanted to think about it more, I would flag it and then I would go on to the next question. And then at the end of, once you get to the last question of that exam, you can go to all of your flagged questions and you can go and you can answer all the ones that you missed. So one, obviously, so you don't miss any questions. And two, sometimes it actually helped me out a little bit more because if I flagged that question and I kept going through the test, sometimes something within another question helped trigger or helped a light bulb go off in my mind where I remembered the answer to that question that I flagged. And then I would go back to that question and answer it and feel confident about that answer. So sometimes that's good. So don't always just be stuck on one question if you don't know the answer. Definitely just flag it and move on and go back to it because chances are it may just pop up down the line or something may help trigger you to remember the answer to that question. So that's basically the gist of the real estate exam and just some, you know, general tips and tricks that I did to help me pass. And I did pass on the first try. So I think what I did really helped out. Like I said, I'm not a good studier. I'm not a good test taker. You know, even in college and high school, I would study, and well, what I thought it was studying, even though I had so many distractions, I would try to study as much as I could. And then I would get to the test and then I would just basically blank out and I wouldn't know anything. And I realized that it was because what I was studying wasn't anything that I was interested in. So once I came about real estate and I actually went to school for a paralegal, which is working in a law firm, I realized that I love law and I love real estate. And once I jumped into law and jumped into real estate, I passed with flying colors with everything that I did because I enjoyed studying it, I enjoyed researching it, and it just was a true passion of mine. And so if this is something that you really love, you'll sit there and you'll study and you'll understand it because you want to, not because you need to. And I realized that that's the huge breaking point is when you actually love what you're studying and interested in what you're studying based on just trying to pass a random test that you don't even care about. So if real estate is a passion of yours and it really intrigues you and you're really interested in it, then you will do fine and you will pass this test. So don't get discouraged. It is a lot. There is a lot of terms. There is a lot of legal terms. And, you know, there are a lot of questions on this exam. And it does take, you know, some time to get through the entire course and study and take the test. But it's all worth it in the end. Just take your time with it and just really enjoy the process of becoming a real estate agent. So it's such a huge passion of mine. It's something that I absolutely love doing. I couldn't picture myself doing anything else besides being a real estate agent for multiple reasons. It's just such a rewarding field in all aspects, such as helping buyers and sellers, just becoming so close with your clients and building such strong relationships. And of course, financially, it's amazing. So if you're someone who is just on the edge of either starting this business, because obviously there's a lot of videos and there's just a lot of negative information out there about becoming a real estate agent, don't let that get in your head. If this is something you truly enjoy, then definitely, definitely do it and don't let anybody stop you. Just go full force for it because once you start getting into it, it's amazing. So I hope this really helped you guys understand or helped you with some different ideas on how to pass the real estate exam or maybe helped you want to dive into becoming a real estate agent. So if you have any other questions, feel free to drop any questions below in the comment section and I'll answer every single one of them. Thank you guys. Have a great day.